Good morning, guys, and welcome back to my channel. So today I have another fragrance battle video for you. You guys seem to really like when I do these videos, and in case you've never been here for a fragrance battle video, it's basically where I take a couple of fragrances that are similar in some way or have something in common, and I compare and contrast them and tell you which one has better performance, which one I like better, or if I could only keep one. So yeah, without further ado, let's get started. And if you haven't already subscribed, definitely head on down and hit the subscribe button so that you don't miss any future fragrance-related content. We have a lot of really exciting stuff coming up over the next few weeks before the holidays. And yeah, let's just get into it. Hi guys, I hope everybody is having a fantastic Sunday. I'm getting ready for another night shift, but I wanted to quickly make a video for you guys. And currently, I am burning my vanilla pumpkin marshmallow candle because I initially bought this in October, and here it is getting closer and closer to Christmas, and I still haven't finished burning my like fall style candles, and I have Christmas candles that I want to get into. So first on our comparison table, we have two from Killian, and this was actually highly requested to tell people which one is better, Love by Killian or Princess by Killian. And the Princess, I just have a little 10 mil travel size, and then I have, of course, a full size bottle of the Love by Killian. If you guys don't know what they smell like, Love is essentially a very sweet caramel vanilla scent. It also has some floral notes in it. I think there's sugar in here as well. This is famous for being what Rihanna wore to the Grammys. I believe it was the Grammys one year. And everybody said she smelled like the best person at the Grammys. And this was a pretty good blind buy. This has really good longevity. It's very, very sweet. It has a really nice scent bubble. At times, I find it can be almost too sweet, like it borderlines on very, very bubblegummy sweet, like those pink bubblegums that have the comics in them. If you know what I'm talking about, it almost is like that sweet. But that being said, it's still a really good perfume and one of my favorites. And you can see I have put a little bit of a dent in the bottle since I've purchased it. Whereas Princess is more of a kind of a sweet marshmallow powdery fragrance. It's not quite as sweet as the Love. But it is really good, and I think it's a really beautiful, intoxicating scent, very sexy. Both of them are very sexy. But between the two, you guys, I definitely have to pick Love. And so this one is the winner for me, and the reason for that is because this one lasts much longer than Princess. This one will last me all day long, where the Princess, I feel, kind of starts to fade after even an hour or two. It really isn't that strong anymore. I feel like I need to reapply it. And this one also just is a bigger perfume. It's got a bigger scent bubble. It's more noticeable. I only have to spray one or two sprays of this, and I feel like everybody in the room will be able to smell me. Whereas the Princess, like I told you guys in other videos, I sprayed quite a lot of this bottle the first time I wore it. I sprayed 10%, and I still didn't feel like I was projecting very much, and I felt the need to go and reapply a different perfume on top of it. So that's my take on these two. So the winner is Love by Killian. So next on our comparison table, we have Alien, the original from Mugler, which you guys know is one of my favorite, 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 favorite perfumes of all time. And we also have one that is newer to my collection, and this is Alien Essence Absolue, also from Mugler. This one, as you guys know, is discontinued, which is a real shame because it is so beautiful. And this has quickly become also one of my most favorite, most coveted scents on my perfume table. So if you guys don't know what the difference is or what they smell like, your original Alien is essentially amber, jasmine, and woody. Amber, jasmine, and woody notes, I believe, yes. And it's very bold, it's very strange, it's very different. It almost smells purple. I don't know if that is because the bottle's purple and I just associate it, but I feel like purple is the perfect color for this. It's very like out there and strange and unique and sensual, boss woman, beautiful. I just love it. One of my favorite, favorite sexy perfumes, nighttime perfumes, but I also like wearing this one for the daytime as well. And Alien Essence Absolue is kind of like the softer, cozier, more sensual sister of Alien. This one has vanilla, it also has cashmere, and it's just intoxicating, you guys. And it lasts forever. Both of these are very, very good in performance. I don't know if I can pick one that is better in terms of lasting power. I think they're both pretty good. And I love wearing both of them. I feel amazing when I wear both of them. So if I have to pick one, you guys, I still would go with my original Alien. Not that this is like, this is not even a fair battle or a fair comparison, because I really, really love both of them and I wouldn't want to have to pick between these two. Both of these are some of my favorite perfumes, and this one, if I could continue purchasing it, this one would be a lifer. So both of them would be on my perfumes for the rest of my life. But if I have to pick just one, I still love my original Alien. I don't know why, it's just something about it. I just love the original Alien. So that's my take on those two. Sorry, that wasn't really that wasn't really a very good battle, because they're both winners in my opinion. Next, we have two from La Vie Belle, and we have La Vie Belle Éclat, which I've had for quite a while, as you guys know, and we also have La Vie Belle Intense. And I've had a couple people comment on my haul video when I first got this that the juice looked funny. Somebody said it almost looked green, and they were wondering if it was my lighting. I promise you it's not the lighting. It actually is this color. It's kind of like a little bit of an off, kind of a darker shade, and I think that's because this one I did get from a discount site, and I think it is an older batch. Like, sometimes you'll get perfumes from some of the discount sites that I think are a little bit older, which doesn't deter me at all. It still smells the same, but I think that's the reason for it. So anyway, this is legit, nothing to worry about. If you guys don't know, I'm sure most of you do, but a lot of perfumes do change color over time, especially if they're heavy on vanilla and other notes like that. They will eventually start to turn darker. So it still smells perfect, still smells like the same perfume. So the difference between these two, you guys, obviously neither of these is the pillar. And as you know, I love the original La Vie Belle. I used to have the original La Vie Belle. The La Vie Belle Éclat is sort of like the sweeter, brighter sister with a little bit of a citrusy opening. It's got bergamot in there, which gives it like a nice little punch in the beginning. And I really like this. As you can see, I have used quite a bit. This is a very easy go-to for me when I don't know what to wear, because it just works and it lasts and it smells good. And you really just can't go wrong with this one. It's just an easy grab and go. It smells really good. Always works. La Vie Belle Intense. This smells a little bit more similar to the original. This truly does smell just like a more intense version. However, this one also has whipped cream and hazelnut. So this one for me definitely goes a little bit more into the winter direction, a little bit more like fall, cozy, sweater weather, that kind of thing. That's what I really get from this one, and I love this one. And you guys, I've actually only worn this once because I've only had it for a couple weeks, but the night that I wore this, it went over really, really well. My partner was obsessed with it. So I think it is a very sexy and attractive perfume. It's also very pretty. I really just enjoyed the scent bubble that I had with this perfume. So this is actually like a really good grab and go as well when I don't know what to wear, especially for the evening. I think both of them are very good for date nights. Both of them are also good for just everyday wear in the cooler weather. And if I have to pick one between the two, you guys, I honestly will pick the La Vie Belle Intense. And I wouldn't have thought that a couple of months ago, but I really enjoy, like, they're both really good, but I really, really like how I feel and just like the scent bubble that I get when I wear the Intense. At the Atomizer, I might pick this one, but actually when I wear them, I really, really like how I feel when I wear the Intense. So both of them are good. I think the La Vie Belles are classics. As I've told you guys before, I don't think you can go wrong with the La Vie Belles. They all have that classic DNA that just works. So that's my take on those two. So the next two that we're comparing before we lose our daylight today is a couple of vanilla and woody perfumes, which I love. That's some of my favorite genres, or I guess types of perfumes. So I have Michael Kors Midnight Shimmer, which you guys know is one of my favorite perfumes. This one is amber and white woods and vanilla, and I think there's some floral notes in here as well. It's just a very sweet, kind of a sparkling woody vanilla, and it's just beautiful. As you guys know, it's one of my favorites. This is a huge compliment getter for me, and it also lasts a really long time on my clothing. So this actually was a very pleasant surprise and turned out to be one of my favorite perfumes. The second one that I'm going to compare is a newer one to my collection, and this is the Seven Virtues Vanilla Woods. I actually have a 50ml bottle of this coming because I decided I liked it enough to get a full bottle. And this is also a vanilla and woody perfume, obviously, but this one also has a note of caramel. So I think this one takes down the floral notch a little bit. I don't think there's as many floral notes in here. I could be totally wrong, but I don't get a lot of floral notes. What I mostly get in this one is sweet vanilla caramel woods, which sounds like heaven. Initially, when I got this, I felt like these two were very close. I thought they were too similar, and I wasn't gonna even worry about this one. I was just gonna keep my Michael Kors Midnight Shimmer. But after I actually wore this one, I noticed that it does have a bit of a caramel undertone, and it makes it so sweet and so sexy. It's kind of along the same lines as like Spiritus Double Vanille, like that kind of a sweet vanilla, whereas the Midnight Shimmer is just a little bit more woody and not so sweet. And if I have to pick a favorite between the two, I think it's a little early for me to do that because I haven't had that much of an opportunity to wear this one. If I have to pick a favorite currently, I'm still gonna go with my Michael Kors Midnight Shimmer. And the reason for that is the amazing performance. With the Michael Kors Midnight Shimmer, I find that this lasts all day. I find that it projects really well. I have a really nice little scent bubble. I get lots of compliments. This one I find is a little bit softer, just a touch softer. So if I have to pick one, I'm gonna go with the one that is the most noticeable and wide projecting, but both of them are amazing and I really like both of them. So I'm gonna have to come back and update you once I actually have my full bottle of this and once I actually wear it, because who knows, this one could become a new favorite of mine. But they're both amazing and I would highly suggest both of them. If you like vanilla perfumes, if you like woody perfumes, if you're looking for something affordable, both of these are quite affordable, honestly, compared to some of the more expensive like niche vanillas. They're both really nicely done and they're both great for date nights, but they're also just great for everyday wear in the fall and the winter. And the last two that we're going to be comparing today are Roses Finis from Mancera and Mon Parfum Cristal from M. Mikaleff. So again, this is one that I thought was appropriate because both of these are rosy gourmand perfumes. They're both sweet perfumes that are also quite prominent in rose. So I don't even know where to begin with this one because both of them are great for different reasons. So the Mancera Roses Vanille smells like caramelized sugar dripped over top of roses. It's a very sugary, syrupy, sweet, really, really strong, almost could be suffocating or headache inducing if you had too much of it. I have to take this in small doses. This is one of those perfumes that I absolutely love the way it smells at the atomizer, but sometimes when I wear it, it can almost be overpowering. But as you guys know, this is still one of my favorite perfumes. It's so beautiful. I haven't smelled anything quite like it. Intense Cafe from Montal is a little bit similar, but in terms of just in general, it's a really bold, sweet, amazing perfume with like monster performance. Long lasting, wide projecting, a little goes a long way with this one. And the Mon Parfum Cristal, in comparison to the Roses Vanille, is less sweet. It's not so sugary, syrupy. It's more of a subtle sweetness. This has toffee and I think vanilla as well. Just look at the way the bottle sparkles. I just love those crystals on there. It's so pretty. So this one also is quite a lot more stronger in the rose note that's in here. This is a more like true, refined, classic rose scent. It really does smell like a fresh Bulgarian rose that you have stuck your nose into, but then it's kind of surrounded in a bed of like vanilla toffee. And so it is sweet, it is rosy, but it's very, very different from the Roses Vanille. This one I would say is more refined. This one is more elegant. It's more classy smelling. This is the one I would wear for that special occasion, formal event, maybe wearing to a wedding, something like that. It's a very like sophisticated, sweet rose scent, where the Roses Vanille I feel like is a little bit more boozy, nighttime, sweater weather, but not quite as elegant as the Mon Parfum Cristal. That's what I would say about those two. Also, the Mon Parfum Cristal probably doesn't project quite as far and it maybe doesn't last quite as long. It's not as bold. In terms of performance, the Roses Vanille definitely wins, but in terms of the scent itself, it's hard for me to choose just one because I really like the classiness and the elegance of the Mon Parfum Cristal. And sometimes, like I say, the Roses Vanille can be a little bit headache-inducing. Like, it can almost be too much for me, where the Mon Parfum Cristal is not headache-inducing whatsoever. It's not too much. It's just the right amount of presence, I guess, if you want to call it that. Between the two, you guys, I'm going to have to say that currently I prefer the Mon Parfum Cristal. That doesn't mean that everybody else will. I think there's a lot of people who definitely would be like Team Roses Vanille who would not like this one because this one is very, very heavy on the rose. And if you don't love rose, you won't like it. 60-70% rose. And the rest is all of the other notes, where this one is like 60-70% sugary sweetness. So they are quite different. So yeah, that's my take on those two. And those are the last two that we're comparing today. So that is it for today's video, you guys. I hope that you really enjoyed. Please feel free to leave me questions or comments down below. Also, head on over and follow me on Instagram if you haven't already. We are really building a nice little fragrance community over there, and I'm so happy to continue to converse with all of you guys and make new friends. And yeah, that's all I have to say for today. So I guess I'll see you guys in my next video. Bye for now.